A stablecoin that's pegged to the dollar, backed by crypto. Huh. Interesting concept. I wonder how this would work. Well, there's actually a project looking to do this on Polkadot, and it's called Acala. This is similar to the MakerDAO CDP system, and we'll explain Acala later in this video and how this system works. In today's KuCoin DigiDive, we're going to be talking about Acala and the AUSD stablecoin. If you guys are ready to go ahead and get started trading on KuCoin, you guys can get 20% off trading fees, links in the description below. So what is Acala? Well, let's go ahead and take a look over at the website, and we're going to go ahead and visit and scroll around. The decentralized stablecoin of Polkadot. So just like Ethereum had DAI, which is the MakerDAO stablecoin, and if you guys didn't know how DAI works, what you do is you deposit Ethereum, you can also do USDC and several other assets inside these different CDP vaults, and you can mint the DAI stablecoin. This is similar to Acala, and they both have similar mechanisms for liquidations in the vault. Except there is one difference on Acala that separates itself from Ethereum. It has to do with the sauce called Horizon Protocol. They allow off-chain liquidations. I'll explain that later in this video. So you can see the AUSD, which is the sauce and the backbone of Acala. This is the decentralized multi-collateral stablecoin. What this means is it's backed by multiple different collaterals. It doesn't just have to be Acala or it doesn't have to be DOT. There are other assets like Bitcoin and Ethereum as well. If you guys don't know much of what a stablecoin is, it's basically a token that looks and seeks to be pegged to the dollar. There are different functions involved in order to do this. Some include buying back and burning the token. Some include liquidations in order to buy back the AUSD supply. And also on the opposite side, increasing lending interest rates in order to incentivize people to repay their loan. There's just multiple different ways in order to do so. We'll talk about these later in the video as well. Just look at AUSD as the central token for the Acala ecosystem. Acala is its own parachain that is on Polkadot. So what's interesting about Acala's chain is that you can use any token that you want for gas. You can use AUSD, you can use DOT, you can use Bitcoin, ETH. There's several different tokens that you guys can use. But bear in mind, even though you're using those on the front end, on the back end, those are used to buy the ACA token. ACA is used for gas. Whether you're spinning it up front or you're using another token, it goes to buy and use the ACA token. It's used for transaction fees, node incentivization, governance, algorithmic risk adjustment, which is like your debt to collateral ratio. So if like, hey, we have 135% on Ethereum, I think we should hire it because it's too risky type of thing. And the TLDR on a collateralization ratio is, let's say for example, I have 130% and I give up $1, I'll be able to borrow 65 cents. That's 135% because I'm over collateralized in order to get that loan. And you will also be able to have pallet deployment. Here's a quick overview of the tokenomics. There is a total of 1 billion tokens. This is the fixed supply. This will be at launch. This is also the max supply. There is no inflation of this token. It's fixed and deflationary. I'll explain the deflationary token mechanics later in this video. They're pretty intuitive, and I think you guys really would like to see this. Here's the distribution of the token, 11% to backers, 49% to the community, 18% to early backers, and 20% to the founding team. If you participated in the parachain auction, 80% of your initial ACA is going to be vesting. They will unvest linearly. You also get the ACA reward. You get 3 ACA for every 1 DOT contributed. So if you gave 100 DOT, you got 300 ACA. And you guys still kind of keep a more of a liquid position of DOT when you participated in this by being able to have LDOT. LDOT can also be used for AUSD. 17% of the supply will be given as rewards. This is like the bootstrapping. And the last 20% will be given as a unlocked token. So you can do whatever you want with this. Here's some features of the AUSD stablecoin. It's pegged to $1. It's censorship resistant, it has multi-collateral, so if Ethereum goes to zero and Bitcoin's still backing it, you still have somewhat of a backing. Now, I'm not saying Bitcoin or Ethereum is going to zero, and I'm not saying they're going to the moon, just giving you guys an example of diversification. It's also secure and efficient, and it's also natively cross-chain. This has to do with the infrastructure of the Polkadot mechanics, which are interoperability. So it's able to work with all these other chains because it has multiple chains on it that are able to communicate with each other. Let's go ahead and get into the details of the ACA token. what can you do with the ACA token? So now that you guys understand AUSD and what it's doing and how it's the stablecoin, let's explain how it works. Every AUSD is backed by several different crypto assets. So these are going to help stabilize it to the US dollar. There are several different functions and levers they can pull in order to maintain that peg, like rising the borrow rate that you're paying, liquidations of the vaults to go back and buy and burn the AUSD token, and other mechanics such as that. The difference between this and something like MakerDAO is the Horizon protocol. The Horizon protocol is using an off-chain worker. It's an automatic scheduler service unique to Substrate. Substrate is what Polkadot is built on. This automates the process of the liquidations and it increases the security and stability of the stablecoin because these liquidations are able to happen like that. Let me go ahead and show you guys a couple of risk parameters of the CDPs that can be adjusted. The stability fee. This is the cost in order to open or close your debt position with the AUSD. If you raise this higher, this is going to disincentivize that. You also have the liquidation ratio. If you borrow assets like Ethereum at 135% collateralization ratio, you can borrow more AUSD than you, or open up a loan and get more AUSD than you would at 150%. So that's the difference. You also have the liquidation penalties. If this is higher, this will disincentivize people to get more risky with their loan value and go out on a limb by having such a high risk position. Also, you can have the debt ceiling. This is the maximum amount of total outstanding debts in AUSD. If you create a debt ceiling and say, look, you can't mint any more AUSD, this will cap it and this will sustain and help with the one-to-one ratio. Now, you can pull all of these levers and tools to disincentivize or incentivize borrowing and lending, but the big backbone in the sauce has to do with the liquidation and auction parameters. And there's different features that can be involved with this. Auction length, which is basically the trigger for starting the auction, like if it needs to be liquidated. The extension, this is to discourage sniping, which will allow a fair auction. Then you also have the bid increment. You can also set tiers, like if someone's just trying to beat it by like a penny, you can say, no, you have to bid by this and this amount. So it sets a parameter and says, look, it's not going to be this type of bid that's like barking at every single penny. And then you also have the lot size. It will be broken up into separate lots. This is really important because if a mega whale just liquidates everyone and they get all this AUSD or all this collateral, they can dump the token and that will hurt the price. However, if you give it to several different wallets, some may want to keep the collateral or the assets and others may want to sell it and others may want to bring it back into the system. So there's different features involved and it's just a better way of decentralizing it. Now let's go and talk about the CDP process real quick. This process is really simple. If you guys are wanting to open up a vault, you go to the section to mint AUSD. This is very simple to do. If you wanted to use Acala, you can deposit Acala, and bear in mind, there is a stability fee of 2.74%. What this means is that's going to be the fees that I'm going to be paying. I can pay this in AUSD or ACA tokens. Either way, whatever happens on the back end, I'm going to be burning ACA tokens because the tokens that I get and the tokens that I use, the stability fee is only able to be paid with ACA. I can pay with any token I want up front, but on the back end, it's going back to buy the ACA token and burning it. So you can simply open it or you can simply close it. You can go to manage, and you can do deposit, withdrawal. It's up to you what you guys want to do, and you can mint. So right now, I just deposited some. I can actually mint more and mint whatever I want and go about it and use my AUSD in whatever I want. I can use this in the earn protocol where I can stake some of the LP tokens with AUSD. So like Acala and AUSD right here. Or I can go and say, all right, I got my AUSD and I just want to speculate and buy the dip on any of these tokens. That's simply how you can do it. It's very easy to use. Lastly, I want to talk about this ACA token. This is going to be your network utility token. I showed you this is going to be used for the transaction fees. I just showed you it's going to be used for stability fees, and it's also going to be for the penalty fees in a liquidation. This is also used as the governance of the network, so you need the ACA token to participate in governance. And lastly, the ACA is going to be used as the backstop. If there's a price crash and a correction in a lot of these tokens, this is the worst case scenario where the ACA token is going to be used to bring the CDPs back to collateral. So keep that in mind when you're holding this type of token. There is risks involved. So overall, what are my thoughts on Acala and the AUSD stablecoin? Well, I think it's really interesting, and I think it's mainly going to be determined based on the adoption of the AUSD token. It's a little bit different model than Maker. It actually adds in token value accrual. I like the Maker ecosystem, but the Maker DAO token fails to have token value capture. It is just used for governance. However, with Acala, you can see that the more demand and the more use of the protocol itself, this goes to burn the ACA token. Similar to like the Terra Luna mechanics, except it's actually backed by collateral with Acala. So as long as there's going to be more demand and use cases for the AUSD stablecoin, I think this will go to drive up the demand for the ACA token. However, the opposite is true. If none of that happens, then there will not be any value that is captured with the ACA token. So just because you create a good value capture doesn't mean value will be captured. The value has to come. I hope you guys enjoyed this KuCoin DigiDive. And if you guys enjoyed this one, make sure you guys subscribe to the KuCoin YouTube channel and check out some of our previous videos we did here, 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 and here. And if you guys want to get 20% off trading fees, links in the description below.